Hey friends, Performance Max is here. The automatic migration from smart shopping to Performance Max is underway. And with this being such a new campaign type, I wanted to provide an update to a video that I recorded a couple of months ago, which was my top tips for setting up a Performance Max campaign. And make sure you stick around to the end because we're gonna review the tips that I went over in my last video, and I also have a free gift that I'm gonna give you. If that sounds interesting, let's discuss. Hey friends, my name is Scott Redgate and I'm passionate about helping small businesses make more and spend less and show you that you have everything that you need to manage your own online marketing campaigns. So we'll jump right in. I created some slides to walk us through my updated tips for Google Performance Max. Okay, so let's discuss Google Performance Max tips for better results, an update from a video that I recorded a couple of months ago. So the first thing that I want to discuss with you is cloning asset groups with different audience signals. So as a reminder, an asset group is a collection of headlines, descriptions, images, videos that you create inside of your Performance Max campaign. Google caps it at 100 asset groups for each campaign, and they're super easy to create. And one of the benefits of having multiple asset groups is that you can add unique audience signals for each of the asset groups that you create. So audience signals are essentially the starting point that you provide to Google to say, hey, find me conversions, find me customers, and here's the starting point that I want you to begin at. And so you can actually upload your own data to create an audience signal. So let's say you have a list of email addresses of your customers. You have the ability to select or type in search terms or go through Google's lists of audience that you believe are similar to your customers who would convert. And then down here, interests and detailed demographics based on their interests, life events, etc. So some of the complaints that I hear about Performance Max campaigns are the lack of data that Google shares about the activity within the campaign, and also just the lack of levers that we can pull as advertisers to really tune the campaign the way that we want it. And so let's say you go the route of creating a Performance Max campaign and you set up multiple asset groups. And let's say that each of these asset groups have the same exact headlines, they have the same exact imagery, videos, etc. And you duplicate with the only difference is the audience signal that you added to each of them. So you're giving each of these asset groups a different starting point, and all of the assets, all of the images, all of the videos are the same. So you have the ability, if you do this, to actually see which of these audience signals, which of these starting points performs better for your Performance Max campaign. And let's say that you are in e-commerce and you use the strategy where you duplicate asset groups with different audience signals. You can actually go into the listing group tab and see the statistics for that particular segment. And a nice benefit of this is you can do it really quickly. It's very easy inside of your Performance Max campaign to clone an asset group with the difference of having a different audience signal. It only takes a couple of minutes. If you want to dip your toes in the water with this, then start out with having two asset groups with two audience signals and then see how each of these asset groups perform. And over time, you might see that one of the asset groups performs better than another. You could consider pausing the low performing one and continually optimizing based on the information that you are getting inside of the insights section of the asset group that is performing well. So the next thing that we're going to talk about is value rules. So not only do I run my own Performance Max campaigns, but I also research and watch a lot of videos for other people in the industry that are running Performance Max. And this is an area that I haven't heard talked about very often. So inside of your Performance Max campaign, inside of the settings section, you can create a value rule. So this is Google's definition. Conversion value rules allow you to set conditions such as audience or location to adjust the conversion values based on your customer's attributes and their relative value to your business. Only one rule can execute for each conversion event. So what this means is you can actually differentiate between the different devices that your audience is using, the locations that they're from, or you can even use Google Analytics to create audiences and treat audiences different inside of your Performance Max campaign. So in layman's terms, value rules allow you to treat your users differently based on their device or location, or if you have Google Analytics set up, you can actually bring in your retargeting audiences and treat them differently inside of Performance Max. So here's the screen, what it looks like with value rules if you were to select location. And if you have Google Analytics configured, you can bring in your audiences from there. Now, what does it mean to actually treat them different? Well, you have the ability to multiply that group's conversion value that the system is optimizing for. So what does that mean? Well, let's say that for your business, you have a particular remarketing audience. So let's say these are people that visit five or more pages on your website and they are really high value users on your website. You could have the ability to bring in that retargeting audience as a value adjustment and multiply their conversion value by 1.2 or 1.3 or whatever you determine, so that Performance Max really tries to optimize and gain conversions from that particular group. And here's another example. So let's say for your business, your service area, there is a particular neighborhood that converts really, really, really well for you. Well, with the value adjustment, you could actually multiply the conversion value for if those users convert what the system is registering as conversion value, so that Performance Max attempts to optimize more for users inside of that group. The next thing that I want to discuss is the presence option within location targeting. So inside of Performance Max, you can specify the location that you want your advertisements to run. And keep note of this section down here where it says target. So you have the option to select presence or interest, and this is people in, regularly in, or who have shown interest in your targeted locations. Or you can select presence. These are people in or regularly in your targeted locations. So let's think about this at a basic level. If you have presence or interest selected, let's say there's someone coming from out of town to visit the area that your business is in, your service area for your business. With presence or interest, you could potentially get those people that are just traveling and visiting your town and that don't actually live there. So let's say you're a plumber or you have a HVAC company. You don't want to waste money on people that don't reside in your area. So that's where you would want to select presence, which is people in or regularly in your targeted locations. So the next thing that I want to discuss is optimizing video for the Google Display Network. So Performance Max, we covered this in the previous video, but it can show across Google's entire platform. So what I mean by that is it can show on YouTube, Gmail, Display, Maps, Search, Discover. I think I got them all. But your ad can show across any of those platforms. And one of the ad types inside of Performance Max is an ad variation that uses your video asset that you uploaded, and it can run as a display advertisement on another website. So one thing to keep in mind is even if you do not upload a video asset, Google can create one on your behalf. And so one thing to keep in mind here, these videos do not autoplay, but what I've found is that if you click these advertisements, if you click this video, it will actually start with the sound off. So one piece of advice is those first few seconds of that video, how would it look if someone did not hear anything, but they just saw the visuals? Are you getting your branding across? Would they know that that advertisement is you and your business? Last but certainly not least, I want to talk about a bid and budget strategy for a brand new Performance Max campaign. So inside of Performance Max, you can select maximize conversion value bidding, or you can select maximize conversions. And one of the optional settings here is to set a target return on ad spend or set a target CPA. Now, for brand new Performance Max campaigns, you're probably better off leaving this unchecked to start to be able to see what Google is able to achieve on their own without you providing any guardrails. So maybe you leave it running for a week or so, but keep in mind that if you do with maximized conversion value, Google seeks to spend all of your budget and maximize the conversions for that given budget. So the end goal from a bidding perspective inside of your Performance Max campaign, if you're obsessed with efficiency like I am, is going to be to set a target return on ad spend inside of the campaign or a target CPA. The reason for this is this could mean that you're not going to spend your full day's budget. And if that's the case, that means that Google wasn't confident that they were going to be able to drive your return on ad spend or your target CPA at that point of the day. And so yes, the trade-off is you might not spend your full budget, but the campaign from an efficiency standpoint is always going to keep that target ROAS or that target CPA in mind throughout all the different parts of the day. So here are some other tips that we had talked about in my previous video, and I'll leave a link in the description below. We had talked about location targeting, really identifying those areas that your potential customers are and running Performance Max inside of those campaigns. Another thing that we had discussed was final URL expansion, and I have that starred because as we've been running more and more Performance Max campaigns, you'll really want to monitor the URLs inside of Google Analytics that Performance Max is driving traffic to. Because with final URL expansion turned on, you might actually notice that you're sending traffic to pages on your website that you do not want to send traffic to. So I think of something like a privacy policy page or a cookies page or something like that. So if you have final URL expansion on, make sure you're monitoring the traffic that's coming in inside of Google Analytics. The next thing that we had talked about was scheduling your ads to optimize your budget around your business schedule. Another thing that we had talked about was picking or manually selecting the call to action for your Performance Max campaign. By default, Google has it set where they can choose it for you. And I've seen a lot of Performance Max ads across the internet where the call to action that Google selected was not in the best interest of that advertiser. So you have the option, why not just pick one yourself? And then we talked about adding campaign extensions, and that really helps out in the search ad side of Performance Max. Hopefully those tips were helpful for you and your confidence in managing your own Performance Max campaign is higher as a result. If you're looking for more money-saving marketing tips, I have a free gift that I want to give you. It's my 7-day online marketing jumpstart. You can get it at scottredgate.com/jumpstart. I created this document because I think there are a lot of businesses out there that can manage their own online marketing and save the money that they would pay a freelancer or an agency. The guide is super simple to understand. It's bullet points and you can complete it in less than a week. And my hope is that after you do, you'll have a lot more confidence that you can manage your own online marketing without wasting money. Hey, thank you so much for watching this video. I would be honored if you would hit that like button and subscribe to my channel so that I can keep making content just like this. Take care.